My first question is, how many of you want to be successful in life? I need to see those hands up. You have a choice whether to succeed or to fail. It's your choice. How many of you want your children not to forget your name? I need to be sure. Because I remember that when I was leaving school, I was considered not to be a nobody. But today my children are happy that I'm their father. The people that people thought were going to metamorphose into something, they are driving Ubers now. They came out with second class Uber, but they are still driving Uber. Your academics does not guarantee you the best in life. Whenever you want to take decisions in your life, there are people that pull you down. You need to leave them alone because your friends determine your values. Your values determine your decisions. Your decisions determine your actions, and your actions determine your results. If your results are wrong, check your actions. If your actions are not the best, check your decisions. If your decisions are not working, check your values. If your values are not the best, check your friends. If you want to change your future, change your friends. Simple. You are the average of five people here. Five. If I know your friends, I'll tell you your future. Simple. Show me who you talk to. Your friends do not only include the people you talk to, they include the books you read, the pages you research online, your mother that you listen to, your father. Those are your friends. The people that influence you are your friends. So I decided to look for new friends. I went online. I looked for Grant Cardone, Russell Brunson, T.D. James. I looked for people that speak, not get into my head. I blast my medulla oblongata 1 hour in the morning, 1 hour at night, every single day. I'm not listening to Wikebe Super. I'm not listening to news. I'm not listening to any other thing. I need things that will change my mind. Show me your friends and I'll tell you your future. If you want to change your future, change your friends. Look at yourself. You dress like your friends. You all look alike. So if I look at your dressing, I know your friends. I know your friends. From the way you talk, I know your friends. Who do you spend time with? What do you read? Iron sharpeneth iron. Iron sharpeneth iron. If you are going to come out as gold, you will need to go through the fire. And trust me, I will burn the rubbish out of your head. I will clean it up. I will not pity you. Some people here have come to my tribe meeting. 30 days, I'll sit down with you. 9 to 10. God help you if you are late. You are in trouble with me. I will remote your medulla oblongata. I will turn it. By the time you come out, you'll be as pure gold. Anything, nothing will shake you. Nothing will shake you. Because you need to build character first. I don't care who you are. Your money cannot help me because you will die without it. A good name is better than lousy. Insanity is defined as doing the same thing over and over and over again and expecting a different result. If you are going to succeed tomorrow, you need to change the way you behave today. Stop that bad behavior. I need you to prepare for dominance. Whether you like it or not, domination has come. It is by choice. A man that I respect so much, his name is Grant Cardone. He was the one that created this word called 10X. 10X is the man called Grant Cardone. Next slide. Grant Cardone was somebody that made a statement that anybody can be successful. Don't let anybody deceive you that it's not everybody that's going to be successful. Everybody can be successful. Every single person can be successful. Including you, including you, including you, including you, including you. Every single person under the sound of my voice can be successful. There are people that are sitting here. They have looked at you, have looked at your result. Your result is showing that you graduate with a third class. Your result is showing that you will not come out as a good student. You are even afraid to go back home to your parents and say, Daddy, Mommy, I have failed. Come on, come on, come on. It is because of you I am here today. They are telling you that the instruction of your lecturers that whether you have failed or not does not mean you are going to fail. I don't care what anybody has said about you. Because somehow in this discussion, you will hear my own story. Success is your duty. It's your duty. It's your duty. It's your responsibility. It's your responsibility to succeed. Your father does not owe you anything. Your mother does not owe you anything. The government does not owe us anything. Nothing. We need to stop it. You are not too young to be rich. I'm going to say it to you. You can be rich. Say, I hear you.
I hear you.
Next slide for me. A lion, the Panthera leo, the African lion, is not the strongest animal in the forest. It is not the tallest animal in the forest. It is not even the fastest animal. It is called the king of the jungle because of one thing. It has an attitude. When a lion wakes up and he sees an elephant, he looks at the elephant and says, this elephant is food. And it goes and attacks that elephant. But if that elephant should step on it one, it will kill the lion. Because the lion thinks that this is food, he attacks it. When the elephant sees the lion, looks at the boss, and not they here, has left, it has disappeared. Because he's afraid of the mindset. What mentality do you have? Your problem is not your location. Your problem is your thinkation. If you can think enough, what you have is more than enough. Your problem is not beneath. Your problem is your brain. If you can change the way you think, people will come to you. Alexander the Great said something, said, I am not afraid of an army of lions led by a sheep. I am afraid of an army of sheep led by a lion. How many lions do we have in here? Talk to me here. I will shake your table because I need you to survive. If you die without releasing your gift, you are ashamed to this world. Because God sent you here with a gift. And that gift, everybody must partake of it. 25 years ago, God said there was a problem in Benin. And he needed you to come and solve it. That's why you landed in Benin. You have to wake up, cultivate your gift so that the world will benefit from you. Small boy, like what's his name, Whiskey, people are eating up his gift. English, he may not be able to speak, but yet, everywhere now, they're paying for his gift. What is your own gift? Your gift is something you can do without any effort. A fish does not need to go to school to learn to swim. What can you do without going to school to learn? That's your gift. All you need to do is to cultivate it. All you need is to groom it. All you need to do is to till the ground, work on your gift. Look for people that can bring out the gift to you and make it happen. Now, once you do that, it will now develop. If you want to 10x your life, there is this word that you need. You need attention. Attention, money follows attention. Wherever there is attention, money will always be there. You need to get attention. You need it. Because money always follows attention. Your simplicity, your quietness will lead to poverty. You need to get attention. Kim Kardashian is a simple girl, but every time she puts the camera on her and she gets attention. The house where Mr. Success lives is on Failure Avenue.